Now today, I'm going to be showing you how to build T flip-flops for Minecraft. So if you don't know what a T flip-flop is, it converts a redstone pulse into a toggleable redstone output. So if you send a redstone pulse into the T flip-flop will turn on, and that pulse will stay on until you send another pulse into the T flip-flop, and then the T flip-flop will turn off. So it's pretty much just a lever, and these circuits are used everywhere. So knowing some of these circuits will put you in advantage compared to a lot of your other friends or people you know. Now the name T flip-flop doesn't mean like flip-flops like what you'd wear in the summer, but it actually just means toggle, so the T is toggle, and then the flip-flop is just flipping between different outputs. So that's how I interpret it. I'm not too sure if that's the real definition of it, so I'll show you an example over here. So if I go to this T flip-flop here, so this is a dropper design, so two droppers and one hopper here, so this is one of like the simplest designs possible. Now if I turn on this button, as you can see the output will turn on. Press the button again, it will turn off. So this is a very simple design. And you can also send an input via this repeater. And also an observer like this. Now here's the design without all the inputs, so I'm going to be showing you how to build this one. So first get your dropper, now face downwards and jump and then place this dropper so it's facing upwards. Put a dropper over here, then put a hopper here, a comparator over here, and then a redstone lamp here, and that's going to be your output. Now put a single item inside here, and then put a button up here. Now the input must be at the top. Now press this button, it's on, press this button again, off. Really simple design. This next design is pretty much the same, but if you have the issue where a player might be standing here, then you can just replace the empty space here with a dropper here, even though you can only take the output from this side here. So this one works pretty much the same way. Now here's another design that's quite similar. It's not the same, but it's similar. But what's good about this design is you can take the output from this side here, and you don't have any risks of losing items. So this one's kind of a win-win. So you do have to input from the bottom here. And you can use an observer with all of these designs. So very simple design. Now if you're wondering, this dropper here is facing upwards. This dropper here is facing in this direction here, so into the hopper. Now the hopper is facing downwards, and then this dropper here is facing into this dropper here. So it just makes a very simple T flip-flop. Now the next designs we're going to look at use observers and pistons. So these ones are a bit noisy, but they're very compact. So here's the first one, so this is like a basic version. So if I get a redstone block, it's on. And a redstone block again, it's off. Now same with this button, so button on, it's on, button on again, and it's off. Very simple design. Now over here, I'm going to be showing you a similar design, but slightly different. So this one is falling edge. So this is the first one, was a rising edge, and this one's falling edge. The way you want to tell if it's falling edge or rising edge is, so I'll show you an example. So when I press this button, this doesn't trigger until the button is retracted. So I'll push the button now, it gets retracted, and this redstone block also gets retracted too. So pretty much what I mean by that is the flipping happens once the button's retracted. Now here's another rising edge one. So you know it's a rising edge because when I push this button, it happens as soon as I press the button. Same with this redstone block. It happens as soon as I put the redstone block down. Now also just want to mention for this design here, it does not work if you're sending the input in with an observer like this. So if I do this, it just doesn't work. And that's because this piston keeps letting go of this observer. And it's kind of just messing with this piston here. It's just not working. So what you can do to fix this is, what we can do is convert this observer here, leave a space here. Now I'll put a note block here, and we'll put a repeater here. This is important. Put this repeater on 3 ticks, like this. And then when we send the input in, it'll work perfectly. This also works with 4 ticks too. Sticky piston at all. Now here is a silent T flip-flop design. So how this works is, this is just a small redstone clock, and it goes round and round repeatedly when this gets unpowered. Now what the input does over here is it just unpowers this repeater here, which is unlocking this repeater, meaning that this can go round and round in a circle. So I'll show you a showcase. So with this observer here, as you can see, it went round once and this turned off. Do it again and it turned on. This also works with buttons too. It does go around a bit more than the observer, but it works quite well. Same with the wooden button too, it still works. Now what I like about this design is it's completely silent. Other than the note block over here, it's silent. So you can just replace this with a different input. And the input to this is just a repeater here. And make sure this repeater's on 2 ticks, otherwise it won't work. It'll be too fast. Now I'm not going to do a tutorial on this design, because you can pretty much just see the redstone light right here. So make sure to take a screenshot or something of this if you're going to build this design. Now next we're going to move on to the ones that use monostable circuits. So we're going to start off with this one, which is a rising edge one. And then a falling edge version. Now the only difference with this one is there's a redstone torch here. So I'm going to press this button. As you can see, it's falling edge. Very nice and simple. Now I'll show you how to build this one, as this is quite hard to see how to build it. So first of all, start off with your button and just place it here. Now put some redstone dust here. Now you can break this block down here and put a sticky piston here. Some stone here. And then a normal repeater here. Now make sure it's a normal repeater. Now put a sticky piston here. A redstone block here. And then a redstone lamp here. Now test if it works. So press the button once and this lamp should be on. Press it again and it should be off. Very simple design. Now here is another design over here. Now this one does use observers, so what this one does is it detects this hopper being unpowered by this redstone and redstone torch, and this is pretty much just a monostable circuit. And this monostable circuit goes into this sticky piston and into this redstone block. This is a nice compact design, so I'll turn it on, and then do it again. Now this one is falling edge as well, just saying. Now here's an old school design. So this one's a falling edge design, and this is just a simple T flip-flop. So I'll show you. As you can see, it's on, and it's off. A pretty cool design, and quite old school as well. I don't really use this design that much, because there's other designs that are slightly better than this, but you can if you want to. Like, I don't really need to do a tutorial on it, because I don't think many people are going to be using this. But I'll kind of just look around to help you see what you need to put. So it's a really simple design. Now here is, in my opinion, the better version and the rising edge version. But like the other one, I don't really use this that much. And I don't think you will either, because there's tons of other designs that are slightly more compact and also faster too. So just make sure if you are building this one, make sure to not forget the redstone torches. The amount of times in the past that I forgot the redstone torches. Well, I kind of now remember them because of the amount of times I forgot them, but make sure to remember them because it's important. Now on to another design which is quite interesting. Now I've used this one before in the past a few times, and it's relatively simple. So pretty much what this does is it unpowers and depowers this hopper clock. So I'll show you in action. It's very fast. Now I really like this design just because of how quiet and slick it is. This is perfect for some sort of like trap or something, where you don't want it to make any noise. So now I'm going to show you how to build this one. So now first, start off by placing a temporary block over here, and then a note block here. Now this is going to be our input, you can change the input if you want to. Now put an observer here, now put a block here, and a block here, and a redstone repeater, and put it on 2 ticks. Now this is going to be our input, you can also change this as well. You don't actually have to have this block here, you could also just put the repeater here as well. But I'm going to be adding a block here, just for really no reason. It doesn't really matter really that much. Now place a block here, so this is going to be the actual two flip-flop itself. So redstone torch here. Now put a block here, a hopper here, and then break this block, and then a hopper here. Then some redstone dust here. A comparator here. Now get a lamp and place it here, so this is going to be our output. And then I'm going to put an item inside here. And then that's your two flip-flop done. Now here is a random design which I came up with, and this uses a boat. So this is kind of based off an old design that I saw, and it doesn't work nowadays, but I've made a way to fix it so that it does work. And really, I don't see any much use for this one because, well, it's got a boat, so that might be quite laggy, but it might be quite cool. Like, if you like boats, a lot, then you probably would like this one. Or if you're in Bottom, this would be perfect for Bottom. So if I press this button here, the T flip-flop turns off, and if I press it again, it turns on. This is a really simple design, and it's actually quite compact too. Now, I don't see much use for this design that much, well, because it's quite laggy because it's got like a boat and everything. And it's also quite slow because of how slow the soul sand and water problem is, because it does take a bit of time for the bubbles to actually pop up and for the boat to start floating up. So I really don't advise building this design at all, but it's quite cool anyway. You might want to like use it in a redstone contraption to show your friends and to make it a little bit more complicated. Making redstone look complicated makes you look smarter. Now onto the last design. This design will change the way you look at redstone forever. This design is the greatest T flip-flop of all time. It's the most compact and the most simple T flip-flop possible. And it's really useful too. It's used in millions and millions of redstone contraptions. And it is the lever. Probably the best T flip-flop in the world, just because of how useful it is and how compact it is. Like, look at it. It's amazing. Like, all of these designs, just scrap them. This is the T flip-flop you should be building. So now, if you need help with any of these designs, any of these T flip-flops at all, make sure to join my Discord server or DM me on Discord. I should be able to help you, maybe, I'm not too sure really. Like, it depends if I get back to you, but on my Discord server, I've got a ton of helpers that can help you. Now, leave a comment down below showing your favourite T flip-flop. I'd love to know. Now, if you want to see another video, so another redstone video on a pulse extender, which is another redstone circuit that you need to know. Now, if you don't know what pulse extenders are, then make sure to watch this video because you're kind of missing out on some vital redstone information. So make sure to check out the pulse extender video. It's very important. And I'll see you in the next video if you're going to watch any more of my videos. And goodbye.